Prepare yourselves for the terrors of the unknown that come only from far beyond the stars.
Captain's log, stardate 1719, apple intergalactic side salad.
You know you make me wanna...
7-4. The evil Deadilorn has turned her enormous galaxy-swallowing spaceship in the direction of Earth and plans to use her army, the Mindless, to enslave the entire human race. Myself and the brave crew of the HMS Splendid are the only things standing in her way for some reason. Receiving a transmission, Captain. On screen. No, on Zoom. No, put it on screen. Oh, I see. Hi, Captain.
I address the puny humans on your tiny little spaceship. There is no escape. Once inside my galaxy eater, no ship can leave, and no transmissions can penetrate my shields. You are lost. The Earth is lost. The human race shall join my Mindless and accompany me on my never-ending quest to consume the cosmos.
Oh, boys, got our dentist appointment next Thursday. Oh, dear.
There is nothing you pitiful humans can do. You have no choice. No one escapes Deadilorn. So, surrender.
Yes?
What?
Yes, how can I help?
What do you mean, help? What do you mean? No, you must surrender.
I must what?
What? Surrender. You must surrender. Your shields are useless.
Oh, am I now? Well, I don't see anyone else running around getting people Kit Kats, do you?
What? Your phasers have no power.
Well, oh, that is true, to be fair, but I do have some lovely new trousers, though.
What? Surrender your souls.
My souls what? Oh, I wish you'd finish her sentences. Now, sodder, cut her off.
With pleasure, Captain.
Scans confirm Deadilorn is correct. We cannot penetrate her shields, nor can our transmissions. We have no way of saving the Earth.
That's where you're wrong, because I have a plan.
Hooray!
Momp and Mimp, I'm transferring you over to the alien vessel. There's no need for you to be caught up in all this. You've lost enough already.
Momp, thank you, Captain.
Doctor Alert, you can go with them and look after them.
Damn it, Captain, I'm a doctor, not a babysitter.
That is an order, Doctor.
Damn it, Captain, I'm a doctor, not a small three-star hotel in the Peak District.
No, shut up. Shields, here's the money for all those Kit Kats. And thank you.
Well, wrap me up in newspaper and pickle me till Monday, Thursday, I'll never thought.
Thank you, Captain. Thank you.
Phasers, you are the cleverest person here. Possibly the cleverest person I've ever known, which I've never told you before. And I should have. I'm sorry.
Oh, thank you, Captain. Thank you.
Now, Phasers, does Deadilorn have a weakness?
I'm not sure, but thinking about it, actually, she did say her ship was powered by the stars themselves, didn't she? And Momp and Mimp said the first thing they noticed before they were attacked was the sky changing colour. So I reckons that Deadilorn must deliberately cause the suns she swallows to go supernova and somehow contains and harnesses that colossal power from those supernovae to power her ship. So if we could find the largest of those suns, assuming it's linked to all the others, which would have to be really, of course, I don't need to tell you that, well then maybe we could do something with that, couldn't we? But as I say, I'm not really sure.
Scanning. There is a red hypergiant star in the center of Deadilorn's ship. Scans suggest it is in a constant state of supernova.
So, if we destroy whatever is containing it, the supernova will be released and destroy the entire ship?
Yes, Captain, but our weapons will not be sufficient.
I know they won't, but the Splendid will. What about all the planets and all the people? There must be billions of them. I'm afraid they've all been transformed into mindless already. Believe me, we'll be doing them a favor. This is the captain. All non-bridge crew are to transfer to the alien vessel immediately. That is an order. Commander yourself, find the weakest point of that hypergiant. Shields, lay in a course and prepare to undock and engage as soon as everyone has transferred off. Phasers, are you able to rig
the... Don't tell me. Am I able to rig the warp core to explode on impact? Well, yes I am, Captain. We're gonna crash the ship into the sun, aren't we?
Correct. This is the Captain. To everyone aboard the alien vessel, the ship is now yours. Dr. Alert is in command. Please follow his orders. As your ship is undetectable and only half of it was swallowed, you should be able to use it to escape and get yourselves to safety. Please inform the Earth of the remarkable sacrifice of the best damn bridge crew a captain could ever ask for. Commander yourself, Lieutenant Phasers, and Ensign Shields, I cannot order you to do what I am asking, so you are free to transfer to the other ship if you wish to do so.
Oh, bugger that! Undocking now, Captain!
Coordinates confirmed.
Ready with the warp core, Captain?
Thank you, everyone. Thank you. Mump, Mimp, you have your orders. Good luck. Shields, get us to that sun.
Aye, Captain. Engaging at maximum.
No enemy action detected.
Just as I predicted. Us puny humans on our tiny little ship can't possibly do anything, and so are being completely ignored. Good old megalomania.
Entering a hypergiant orbit.
Is everything ready, Phasers?
Oh yes, Captain, absolutely. Warp core will explode the moment the ship impacts. Don't you worry about that, oh no.
Thank you, everyone, for everything. You've got me where I need to be. Mump, Mimp, now! Goodbye, my friends.
Mump, Mimp, welcome aboard.
What? What's happening? Where's Captain?
He no longer needed us. He has saved our lives.
Captain!
Just a few more seconds.
Puny human, what are you doing? Desist at once, at once. Mindless, board his vessel and transform him.
You will be like us.
On behalf of all the puny humans and any other life forms out there, we are not mindless. We are not slaves. Our hearts and souls are what make us who we are, and we will defend them until our last breath. We may have flaws. We may have faults. We may get things wrong. We may still have a hell of a lot to learn. But one thing we do know is that we will never, ever be like you!
No!
True in spirit and brave of heart, our heroes come from far beyond the stars.